And the fourth aspect to this, again, this is for larger curation projects where you have more than one curator. This is something you don't need to think as much about if you have a very small project with just one curator. But when you have, let's say, 5 or 10 curators, you really want to have consistency in how data is extracted, how data is annotated, so that your entire curated data set makes sense. And we find one of the most useful ways to achieve this is that the curators who originally develop the curation, they create something we call a curation protocol. It's basically a manual for curators that describes what information is to be extracted, how is to be extracted, you know, what standards to use, with examples, and then have a set of training documents that have already been pre-extracted. Maybe a curation tool that supports you. And then when you have a new person coming in on the team to get trained as a curator, they first spend time on curating these training documents and extracting information. And then you have an experienced person, trainer, an editor, review this and hand it back to them in an iterative process, explaining to them where it should be done differently until they are on the same process like everybody else, and until they are consistent in the way they extract information from these papers. That will help you to get much better, cleaner data sets out of that process. And in our case, this is actually a significant investment to get curators to that high quality level. And we spend up to half a year before curators move from our training environment. So you have a separate environment for doing this, training environment, into our production environment where they're actually curating data that goes into our database. And I think as an aside, this has also been one of the reasons why many public curation projects haven't worked that well, because if people are just curating without any training how to do this, then it's very heterogeneous what you get out of this.
QIAGEN. Sample to insight.